Seahawks, Steelers, coming up on EA Sports. We welcome you to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania for today's game.
Back in your days when you had to take on a team from the AFC, didn't know them all that well. What was it like as we have this little interconference matchup today?
Well, I thought back in those days, Jim, we were about ready to show them what toughness and hard-hitting was. Today it's a little different, but I'll tell you this, this NFC team, they are hard-hitting bunch.
The Seahawks will take the snap from the 25. Doug Baldwin makes the catch. No one's going to get him now. The 10, and he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run.
Nowadays, so many kids, they grow up, they want to be wide receivers. I don't blame them. They're out there, they get to catch the football, they get to score touchdowns, they get to do dances, and you're not really allowed to hit them either. What a job.
The point after try is in the books. That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. First down at the 20. Bell, right side. And picks up maybe 3 or 4. He emerged as quite a find after being drafted in the 4th round out of Clemson. Right away in his rookie year, making plays and finding the end zone often was Martavis Bryant.
Another Clemson wide receiver. People forgot about him because Sammy Watkins was one of his teammates. But he has the size and the speed, and he makes a great target for any quarterback.
Coming to the line at the 39. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Chancellor's able to read that play and make the hit.
The Seahawks defense is so fast and so powerful. That time of the run play, they just overpower the offensive line and they tackle the runner for a loss.
Pitting the Steelers against the Seahawks, a rematch, Bill, of a Super Bowl back in 2005 in Detroit when Bill Cowher and Pittsburgh took home the Lombardi Trophy.
They sure did. A couple plays I remember about that game. Fast Willie Parker on the long touchdown run for the Pittsburgh Steelers, and Antoine Randall-L sweeping from left to right, throws the football from the wide receiver position to Hines Ward for the touchdowns. Those were some outstanding plays in that game.
It's Earl Thomas who makes the tackle.
Le'Veon Bell shows his versatility. Good power run in the red zone that time by him.
Coming up to the line at the 7. Bell will get it on the toss. Sherman's in on the tackle.
The offense is so close right here. They just need to show a little power and punch this in the end zone and get that touchdown.
First and goal from the 1. Brings it in for the score in the end zone. They tie this game midway through the first. They were a little sluggish there at the start, but it looks like they have some fight in them after all, partner.
Jim, you're right. It was a slow start, but it doesn't matter. It's a long game at 60 minutes. It's not always going to be perfect, but that was a nice touchdown there.
Baldwin's got it on the return. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. The Seahawks coming back onto the field on offense. They took it down the field for a touchdown the last time they had it.
Listen, momentum is on their side. When you have that going for you, keep the defense guessing at what you're going to do. So I think it's very important to stay aggressive in this situation.
And he makes the catch. No, the ball comes out. The ball is knocked out of his hands. What player to watch on the outside? He caught a touchdown in Super Bowl 49 is Doug Baldwin.
Yeah, he's just a receiver who goes up, makes tough catches. He just competes like nobody else, and there will always be a spot in the league for him.
That's his first reception today.
What must it be like to be able to go down there and make a play like that? How about it? One-handed catch, that was special.
First down at the 33. Launching it deep. The Seahawks are in the end zone for the touchdown. They take the lead here late in the first quarter with the touchdown.
Yeah, nothing like it. Before that first quarter was up, they found a way to get in the end zone and get that score to take the lead. And, hey, that's a good feeling.
The Seahawks ready here for the kickoff. And a touchback.
The Steelers offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
Going to take it the distance. The 10, touchdown. And that touchdown, Phil, here late in the first, ties the game.
Yeah, it ties it up, and it gets him out of a little hole, and, of course, it gives the offense a lot of confidence. And on the defensive side, they have struggled early, but maybe they can start to pick things up.
The Steelers getting set to kick it away. Baldwin's got it. Able to move past the 20. The 23. The Seahawks really have this offense cranking, Phil. They scored on their last two series.
You know what we see now in the NFL, so many different ways to move an offense. Screens, run plays, power plays, trick plays. Right now, everything working on the offensive side.
The receiver comes down with it. Somehow he outbattles him for the catch. It sure looked like an interception for a while there, Phil. But how about the effort by the wide receiver?
Never give up, Jim. That's what you do as a wide receiver in this league. And he didn't that time, and he gets the catch over the defender. What a job.
Had it, but dropped it. In the secondary, keep an eye today on William Gay out of Louisville.
Yeah, he has proven that, Jim, he's a versatile defensive back, and that's what you need. A guy that's hung around, he's got experience and talent.
Ball comes out.
This defense is ready to pounce here early in this game as a third and long play is coming up.
They sure are. There's no doubt about that. They got themselves in a good situation here. If I'm the quarterback now, third long, I would be very cautious and conservative.
Looking to go deep. The ball is taken out of his hands.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
And it's a fake. They're running a fake. Ryan's marked down at the 41.
Well, anytime you run a fake punt and you let somebody throw the football besides the quarterback, even though the play is there and everybody's wide open, you still have a chance of not making it work. Why? Because the guy throwing it is not an NFL quarterback.
My goodness, what a hit. And the ball falls incomplete. one of the keys to this Seattle defense is Earl Thomas.
Earl Thomas, probably the fastest safety in the National Football League. They let him stand back there and truly